There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. And our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions in my heart, like why are we here and where do we go, and knock on me so hard. It's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars when we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. Just might find their way into my dreams tonight, but I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do, but if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between. With only two, just me and you, not so many things we got to do, or places we got to be. We'll sit beneath the mango tree now. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. We're somewhere in between together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. Combination of words I could say, but I will still tell you one thing, we're better together.
I think it's appropriate that we start with the L'chaim. L'chaim. So first of all, welcome everyone. We have a very, very special celebration. Ilan Sinelnikov is going to be marrying Melissa Sachs. This is the most special day of their life and all of us over here who are celebrating together with them. What a special day, what a joyous occasion. All of us here celebrating. And we're going to start off with a traditional bedecken. Bedecken is a word in Yiddish which means to veil. And that's because at this moment, to start off the celebration, Ilan, the groom, the chatan, is going to be led by the two fathers, that's his father and Melissa's father, over to the bride, to Melissa, and he's going to place a veil over her face, which will remain there for the duration of the chuppah. And the reason why we place a veil over the face of the bride for the duration of the chuppah is to remind us of our matriarch Rebecca, whose Hebrew name is Rivka, just like our bride, Rivka. And Rivka, the first time she sees her future husband, Yitzchak, Isaac, she covers her face out of modesty. She places a veil over her. So we do that to remember that. But it also indicates that our groom, our chatan, is marrying Melissa for her, not just for her external beauty and charm, but also for her inner qualities. So we cover the outside, and at this moment we focus on the inside. And so Ilan will be led by the two fathers over to Melissa with very joyous music, and we invite everyone to join along. And right after the bedecken, the two fathers, Brian and Kostas, will give Melissa a very personal and private blessing. There is no script for this blessing. These are words that will come from their heart to the bride's heart on the most important day of their life and of her life. So ladies and gentlemen, please join us for the bedecken. Hey, la, 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 welcome to the Jewish wedding ceremony of Ilan and Melissa. It means so much to the family that everyone is here celebrating in person or virtually. And of course, the family greatly appreciates it. I think at this point, if anyone would like to take pictures, you may do so, but please turn down your cell phones as we get ready for the chuppah. As you can see, the chuppah is a canopy which stands upon four poles. And the reason why we have a chuppah is because the chuppah is like a private domain. And it's a private domain where the groom is bringing the bride into his house, into his presence, into his life. And upon arrival at the chuppah, the bride will circle the groom seven times. And with these circles, the bride is creating a wall. And she's creating a wall, albeit an invisible wall, around her husband, into which she, and only she, will step into, to the exclusion of all others. Additionally, the walls of the chuppah remind us, and the circles remind us, of the seven times that Joshua and the Israelites circled the city of Jericho when they came into the land of Israel, and then the walls crumbled down. And similarly, the bride circles her groom seven times to break down any remaining walls or barriers that are between them. My dear friends, please rise as family members, the groom, and then the bride make their way to the chuppah.
רק בתחיל את ליבך, אם תרצי לחייך, מאבוא עד אליי. להרגיש מקרוב, ואותך לאהוב, עד אחרון הימים. כשאת כאן בסביבה, ניצוצות אהבה, מאירים את עיניי. לקולך עליים, שירת מלאכים, מהדהד באוזניי.
Melissa comes
with her parents, and they're going to walk around and follow them in the circle. Mela Adava, at Posatela, Mediani Margot, Esimha Lehai, Melibi Achonhe, Esuare.
Speak.
Hasidic philosophy teaches that several generations of departed ancestors of the bride and the groom descend from the world of truth to attend the wedding of their offspring. And so at this moment, we invite the souls in the presence of the parents, grandparents, and great-grandparents to join us at the chuppah. This chuppah is very special as its roof is made from the talit of Ilan's great-grandfather and Melissa's grandfather. We invite their souls, as well as all the other ancestors, to join us at the chuppah. Last but not least, we invite God Almighty to join us at the chuppah and to bless the couple. We welcome God to the chuppah with the traditional words of Baruch Haba.
Baruch Haba mi adir al hakol mi baruch al hakol mi gadol al hakol mi dagol al hakol o yevarech o yevarech o yevarech o yevarech o yevarech es hechasan v'yes hakal.
The mightiest of overall, he who is blessed overall, he who is the greatest overall, and he who is the distinguished of all, may he bless the bride and the groom. You may be seated. Our sages advise us that the marriage ceremony should entail three aspects: the giving of a valuable, such as a ring, the presentation of the ketubah, and the adjournment to a private room representing intimacy. According to the Torah, every legal procedure in Jewish life calls for two kosher witnesses. Thus, two kosher witnesses stand under the chuppah and witness the procedures. Myself and Rabbi Glasner will be the witnesses, to the exclusion of all others. At this moment, we're going to fill a glass of wine and say a blessing over the wine and a blessing over the marriage ceremony.
Savri moronon, baruch atadino, eloheinu melech ha'olam, boirei pri hagofen. Baruch atadino, eloheinu melech ha'olam, asher kiddushonu b'mitzvoisov, v'tzivonu al haroyoyz, v'osar lonu es harusoyz, v'hitir lanu es hanesu ois lanu al yidei chupo v'kidushin baruch atadonai mekadesh amo Yisrael al yidei chupo v'kidushin.
At this time,
the groom, the chatan, will place a ring on the bride's finger, and the giving of a ring by the chatan to the kala is the most fundamental aspect of the chuppah ceremony. And the perfect roundness of the ring symbolizes an unspoken prayer, that just as the ring is made of plain gold without any blemishes, so too it is hoped that the marriage will be one of simple beauty, free from strife or conflict, which may ruin its perfect roundness. You know, they say that sometimes there are three rings. There is an engagement ring, there is the wedding ring, and then there is suffering. We pray that at this wedding, and we are sure that in the life, the many years ahead of Melissa and Ilan, there will be only two. We have done the first part, the chatan giving the kala the gold ring, and we now move on to the second part, which is the reading and the presentation of the ketubah. The ketubah, which was instituted some 2,000 years ago, it's written in Aramaic, and it is the first historical marriage document which addresses and protects the rights of a woman in marriage. In the ketubah, and Ilan pledged that he will work for, provide for, honor, and support his wife for the rest of his life. The ketubah will now be read, and then the groom, the chatan, will give the ketubah to the bride. Baruch Hashem, b'chamishi v'shabbos, shivos ha'yom l'chodesh yar shnas chamesha salafim, u'shva meyos yishmoinim v'achas l'briyas oylom, l'minyin shonimonin kan, Boca Raton, Florida. Eich ha'vachor, Ilan ben Konstantin, omar lo la'da'itza, Rivka Gevira, bas Baruch Yisrael, havilil intur kadas Moshe v'Yisrael. V'ano eflach v'oikir, v'ezoin v'farnas yisichlichi, k'hilchas guvrin yodoin, the polchin, a mikrin, vazodin, and farnesin, and shayin, bekushta. The hivna lichi kesek, sabosi, zuzeme, the chazelichi midrabona. Umizonaichi, uksosaichi, visipokaichi, umeal of a sichi, koirach kolaro. But svias moras rivka gvira itzada, vavasli into. The don adunya dan alas levi beavua, be mekesa, be mizo, be mtachitin. Imon and delvusha, beshmushidira, beshmusha, the arsa. Hakol kibul alov ilan chasan dinan b'chamishim zekukim kesef tzoruf. Utzvi ilan chasan dinan v'hoisef lom in delay oid chamishim zekukim kerev tzoruf acherim k'negdom. Sach hakol meir zekukim kesef tzoruf. V'kach omar ilan chasan dinan achray ishtar k'suvta do nidun yudem tesefta do akavus olav agarasim basroi lisparim kol shvar arnichsim v'kininin d'islit chuz kol shmaya d'kenoi v'da'osi dan olamikni nichsin d'is moin achrayis. The last line of Christ. Kulan yein are chroin var voin lefroim in hoin shark soup the dom dun yudom to sef the dom in oi, va filu min glimut al kaspoi, va chaye, a boss of chaim in yemidinan al olam. Va chrayis uchem shark soup the dom dun yudom to sef the dom, kibul alov, ilan, chasandinan, kachemer karshari, ksubois with the sef the eighth and argument of Nos Yisrael, va isuin ketikun chachamenuzal, deluka smachto, deloy ketuvsi de shtore. The Kanina min Ilan ben Konstantin, Chasandinan, Lamaras Rivka Gavira Bas, Baruch Yisrael, Itzada, Al kol ma de kosov um furish lil be mona be kosher miknebe hakol shore be kayem. Nuum zundel henef ben Pinchas leib ein. Nuum nachum hillel ben Moshe ein. Wouldn't be an authentic Jewish wedding if there wasn't a sermon. I'm going to share some words in honor of this special occasion. We are all here celebrating with Ilan and Melissa on this very, very special day, the most special day of their life. And tonight in the Jewish calendar is also one of the most special days. It's known as Lag BaOmer. In Lag BaOmer, we commemorate the passing, amongst other things, the passing of one of the great Jewish sages, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, who passed away some 2,000 years ago. And he requested that on the day of his passing, it should be a day of celebration and joyous occasions. And there are many fascinating and awesome stories related about this exceptionally great Torah sage, Rabbi Shimon. In the Zohar, which was written by Rabbi Shimon, and which incidentally is the foundation for esoteric Torah teaching and the Kabbalah, it is related that the story, once the Jewish people were in urgent need for rain, and the people approached Rabbi Shimon, and they say, Rabbi, can you please pray? There's a terrible drought happening. Rabbi Shimon opens up and he says the very famous verse, Hinei matov u'manayim shevet achim gam yachad. Behold how good and how pleasant it is with the dwelling of brothers in unity. Rabbi Shimon expounded on this verse and miraculously the skies opened up and it began to rain. There are many commentaries which explain this story and explain this verse, but today I'd like to share a thought with you. Shevet achim gam yachad, when brothers live together in harmony. This verse speaks of you at this moment, Melissa and Ilan, our chatan and kala, as you stand here under the chuppah on the most very, very special day of your life. The blessing of your well-wishers, and something obviously you also pray for, is that your home and your marriage, there should be peace, there should be harmony, there should be brotherly love, and there should be unity. But if you notice, the psalmist, however, goes a step deeper and he says that there is another important ingredient. He doesn't say Shevet Achim Yachad. He says Shevet Achim Gam Yachad. What does the Gam also? What does the word also include? And if I may humbly say that the word Gam Yachad may be translated also with the one, referring to God Almighty. And that is that the two of you not only live together in peace and harmony among yourself, but that you bring God into your life, so that your brotherhood, your achim, your shevet achim, is directed and guided by the teachings of God in the Torah. Hinei matov u'manayim, how good and how pleasant it is, shevet achim gam yachad, when the two of you bring the Creator of the world into your marriage and into your home. Melissa and Ilan, you were both raised in very strong Jewish homes. And as you build your own home, hopefully it won't just be the two of you, but you will bring God into your marriage. And as faithful partners, all your decisions will be made, not just between the two of you, but also having in mind the interests and the desires of your third partner, Almighty God. And that is the message of today of Lag BaOmer, that not everything is as smooth sailing as we'd like it to be. Life could have hiccups, and sometimes we even make mistakes in life. But if we remain focused on this which Rabbi Shimon teaches us, Hinei ma tovu ma noem, how good and how pleasant it is, the Torah teaches us, and God Almighty promises us, that when God is our third partner of marriage, there will be unity and there will be peace. And then, for dealing faithfully with your partner, God will reciprocate and do his share to bring you, please God, in the very near future, a bunch of little Sinelnikovs running around the house, and it'll bring you material and spiritual success, or as we say in Owings Mills, Bracha Vatzlacha, and of course, Mazel Tov, good fortune. Amen. We're going to refill our cup of wine, and then we're going to recite seven blessings, the Sheva Brachot under the Chuppah. That's right, Sheva Brachot, Naomi, beautiful. Sheva Brachot. Correct. And we're going to honor six individuals with reciting our blessings. For the first blessing, the first two blessings, which the first one is a blessing over a glass of wine, and the second blessing, we make a blessing that, and we recite and we proclaim that everything was created in God's honor. And this blessing is also dedicated to everyone over here, thanking you for joining in the Simcha. I'd like to honor the brother of the bride, Matt Sachs, with the first two brachas.
Amen.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Shehakol Bara Lichvodo.
Amen. For the third blessing, which is Yotzer HaAdam, we thank God for creating us, the human people. This blessing will be recited by cousin David Levitt. Amen. For the fourth blessing, the blessing of Ashi Yatzar, we thank God for creating man in his own image, in a way that man and woman together can build an everlasting home. We'd like to honor the father of the groom, Kostas Sinelnikov. Amen. For the fifth blessing, the blessing of Sos Tassis. This refers to the city of Jerusalem, which awaits the return of her children from exile. This blessing will be recited by Uncle Harvey.
First Tarsus, Mesagel Hakara, Bay Kibbutz, Bahanea, Lesokha, Bem Simcha, Baruch Ata Adonai, Mesamer, Stixion, Bemanea.
Amen. For the sixth blessing, Samach to Samach, we acknowledge that the bride and the groom, and we bless them that they should grow in their love for each other. And this blessing will be recited by Ori, the brother-in-law of the Chatan.
Baruch
Samach tesamach rachim ahubim. Kesimchacha yetzircha began eden mikedem. Baruch ata Adonai. V'sameach hatan v'kala.
Amen. And for the last of the seven blessings, the last of the Sheva Brachot, we make a blessing and we bring the ceremony to the height of joy with prayers for love, friendship, peace, and joyfulness. And this blessing concludes with a prayer for the coming of our righteous Mashiach. And the blessing will be recited by the father of the bride, Brian Sachs.
Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher bara sasam v'simcha, chasam v'kala, gila rina, ditza v'chedva, aval v'ava, shalom v'reyus. Mehera Adonai Eloheinu, yishoma bar Yehuda, v'chutzos Yerushalayim, kol sasam v'kol simcha, kol chatan v'kol kala, kol mitzalos chatanim mechupatam, v'na'arim, Mishnei Nignosam, Baruch Atah Adonai, Misameach Vatan, Im Hakalo.
Amen. To drink the rest of our glass of wine before the glass is broken, we'd like to honor Cousin Robert.
Is he here?
Robert, you're up. To conclude the chuppah, the groom, the chatan, will break a glass with his foot as a remembrance of the destruction of the Holy Temple in Jerusalem. And as Jews, even in the height of our personal joy, we must remember our communal pain over the loss of our Holy Temple. Ilan, they say that when you put your foot on the glass, you have to remember that this is the last time you put your foot down in this marriage. The bride and the groom have requested that a special song will be played at this moment to express our yearning for the building of our holy temple and the coming of our righteous Mashiach.
See you. shoni mlehi ki imo eskelefi
Please allow Mr. and Mrs. Senelnikov to leave the chuppah and head over to their private yichud.
To celebrate. It's crazy that today has finally come, and I'm so excited and love you guys so much.
That was a beautiful service. I love you guys so much, Mazel Tov. We can't wait to celebrate. We miss everyone who's live streaming, and Mazel Tov. This was amazing.
Thrilled that all of you are here with us to share in this beautiful, joyous occasion, the Simcha, with us and our family, and wishing Ilan and Melissa many years of health and happiness together. And Sherry wants to say a few words as well.
We're just so happy everybody can join us, even if it's virtually. And we love you guys, and thank you for joining us. And this is just such a special day. We love Melissa and Ilan, and I know they're just gonna have such a wonderful future together.
Our dear family and friends, thank you so much for joining our ceremony, for our Simcha. And thank you so much. And we love you all, and we wish all good for Ilan and Melissa, and happy to many years, and happy birthday to new Jewish family.